Referring to the previous video where we set up an XY grid, you can also set up what they call an X zone or XZ drawing. It's sometimes also known as an X grid drawing. So what I've done is I've copied the Demo 25 drawing and created a new blank drawing, Demo 30. We've still got that little line to allow us to place the grid like so. So what we're going to do, we're going to go to the Demo 30 drawing there in the Project Manager, right click, Properties, Drawing Properties. We then go to the drawing format like we did before, but this time we're going to set it just to X zones or X grid, or sometimes an XZ drawing it's called. Click on the setup. It's very similar to the XY grid, but we're only spacing horizontally this time. Again, we need to pick on our origin. Using our endpoint snap there, we snap to the end of that small line that we placed in the drawing earlier. And we need our zone labels. So again, we'll make sure that these are all in place like so. You'll notice I've just put my caps lock on there. It's always good to make sure that you do these in capitals. Otherwise, they do look a bit unprofessional, to be honest. Capitals work better on these grids for the X and Y and just the X zone setup as well. So we're going to put a comma there. And then we're going to go B, comma C, comma D, comma E, comma F, comma G, comma H. So we're going to have 8. I then click on OK and click on OK again. That's all set up in the drawing properties. I then need to go to the schematic tab on the ribbon, insert wires, wire numbers up here, click on the down arrow and select X zones setup. Same dialog box appears, but it's for X zones this time rather than the XY grid. We insert the zone labels like so. We click on OK. And as you can see, there they are there. So if I zoom in and pan, A, B, C, D, and so on. And it's the same process as before. If I now go to the icon menu, we'll pick that motor again like we did last time. So I'll go to motor control, three-phase motor, and I'll place that there underneath the A. M-O-T-A. Click on OK, and there's M-O-T-A there. So if I now click on that component, right click and use the move component on the right hand button shortcut menu. Move it across to C, let's say there, like so. It updates. OK to retag, and it updates to C. So sometimes you will use just X zones horizontally. Sometimes you will use X and Y grids where you've got here A, B, C, D, and going vertically 1, 2, 3, 4, perhaps. These can be numbered and labeled exactly how you want them to be. I've done it very simply with A, B, C, D and 1, 2, 3, 4. Nothing to stop you using different combinations of letters and numbers to make that work for your particular AutoCAD electrical project.